adoption of the agenda. Are there any changes to the agenda? And do you have any changes?
Mr. Chairman, I do. I have two. First of all, with respect to a matter of some time sensitivity, I would request the board add as new business item three a proposed resolution that would reassemble the ethics board for the purpose of hearing the pending ethics matter. Just because we've got a pending ethics complaint, we need to get that done. I have passed out a proposed resolution to your stations, and that would take a 4/5, Mr. Chairman, to add that.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion. We have a second for a time-sensitive item. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. Item number two. Regarding.
I thought we were addressing this at the end of the agenda.
Mr. King, we are addressing the resolution regarding the current Board of Ethics at the end of the agenda, but that's different than the ordinance itself. Mr. Chairman, do you want me to go ahead and proceed?
Yes, please.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, public hearing number two this evening is what will be the second public hearing related to Forsyth County ethics ordinance, which is ordinance number 77, and it proposed fairly significant modification thereof. This has been in the works for some time, and really I don't need to go give you a 15-20 minute presentation. I can distill it fairly quickly. This would effectively, once this is adopted, it would disband the existing standing ethics board as it currently exists and would replace it with an ad hoc panel of out-of-county attorneys that would comprise an ethics panel that would be assembled on a case-by-case basis every time an ethics complaint is tendered. We would use some models that have been done in other jurisdictions. We would get basically names of attorneys that have offices outside of Forsyth County. We would have them on standby. When an ethics complaint comes in, there would be a process of basically randomly selecting a panel of three and then assembling those individuals. They would come together. They would hear the complaint very much in the ordinary course that is done now, and they would render their decision. The hope is that this will take any potential element of conflict of interest or associational source of interests out of the ethics equation altogether. That's the background for this. With respect to their powers, one significant thing is that this proposed ordinance would take away the existing Board of Ethics rights to conduct investigations. This ethics panels would not be empowered to do that. They won't be standing. They will be complaint-based only and then adjudicate those complaints. The other significant modification is this would strike from our code what is in our code now, which is the wrongful use section. Right now, there is in our ethics code that if there is in fact a dismissal of a complaint or a complaint that is deemed to be frivolous, it would result in a potential wrongful use finding based upon, I think, clear and convincing evidence, a fairly high standard, but can actually allow fee shifting to go against the party that made the complaint. If this is adopted as it is currently drafted today, that wrongful use ordinance should go away. This would be our second public hearing, Mr. Chairman, the Board of Commissioners could adopt. And to go back to Commissioner Tam's point, even if you adopt this evening and therefore this becomes the law, I am still going to request that we approve a resolution assembling the old assemblage of our Board of Ethics to hear a complaint that is pending right now. There's a couple of reasons for that. I'll explain it when we get to that in the agenda, but I just want to let you know in case we get to that point, you're like, why did this happen? I'll explain it to him. Mr. Chairman, this is the second public hearing you can adopt.
Thank you. Is there a motion from the board?
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion. We approve.
Oh, wait. Do I need to open a public
hearing? Yes, you must have
right here. Yeah. Yes, sir. I would entertain a motion to open the public hearing.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote. And that passes unanimously. Is there anyone wishing to speak in favor of this proposed amendment? Is there anyone wishing to speak in opposition? Is there anyone wishing to say anything not, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved. Second.
Have a motion and a second, if there's no discussion, please vote. And that passes unanimously.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we approve the proposed amendments to Forsyth County Ethics Ordinance as described by the county attorney.
Second.
We have a motion, we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. I see we added an item regarding the ethics board.
Mr. Chairman, we did. This next item added by motion voted this evening on a constant basis was a resolution of board commissioners acknowledging the holdover terms of certain ethics board members and acknowledging withdrawal of resignation of a single ethics board member for purposes of concluding a pending ethics complaint. And I will say this, Mr. Chairman, I am mindful the board of commissioners has modified the ethics code effective, quite frankly, this after this evening, but we have a pending ethics matter filed under the terms of the old ethics ordinance. And quite frankly, for a number of reasons, it would make sense to go ahead and have the old board adjudicate and preside over that matter. This resolution would do a couple things. First of all, it would acknowledge the makeup of the Board of Ethics as it existed previously. It would acknowledge the holdover capacity of three of the board members. It would acknowledge the waiver of the resignation of Mr. Perry such that he can serve for this final matter. And it would therefore allow them to assemble as quickly as possible to hold the November meeting and then go ahead and hear that last complaint. Also, the ethics attorney, Mr. Logan Butler, has accused from this matter, and this resolution would also appoint Attorney George Weaver, who the ethics board has used previously, as the hearing officer for this last ethics adjudication. I should point out that a lot of what the Board of Commissioners has done this evening, it's just not academic that this will be the last time they adjudicate. It is official that this will be the last matter they will hear, because once their service on this matter is completed, they will be dissolved as a matter of law. Mr. Chairman, I would ask your gracious indulgence of my fourth whereas paragraph, where it states, whereas the pending ordinance has not been placed into lawful effect. If the Board of Commissioners adopts this evening, I would ask that you strike that fourth paragraph because you have, in fact, adopted the new ordinance. That's my recommendation.
Thank you, Counselor.
The fourth paragraph in the whereas, folks, that's the one that needs to come out.
What's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion we adopt the resolution of the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners acknowledging the holdover terms of certain ethics board members and acknowledging the withdrawal of their resignations of a single ethics member board for the purpose of conducting a final pending ethics matter of those other purposes as displayed, striking the fourth paragraph.
Second.
We have a motion, we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote. Passes unanimously. Counselor, is there any other business to come before this board?
There is not, Mr. Chairman. I don't need an executive session this evening.
Thank you. We want to.
Is
there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote. That passes unanimously.